I'm Monica, and today I'm going to discuss the history of the band Kansas. The band Kansas has produced many hit singles, one being Carry On Wayward Son. But who are these people making fans go crazy? Between the time period of 1970 to 1983, the band Kansas consisted of the group members Phil Ehart, Rich Williams, Billy Greer, Steve Walsh, Robbie Steinhardt, Dave Hope, and Carrie Livren. During this period, the band gained popularity with their classical rock style songs. One of their hit singles was Carry On Wayward Son, which peaked number 11 on the US Billboard Hot 100. Kansas' musical style was a fusion of hard rock, southern rock, and progressive rock, all influenced by many other bands. That was so bad.
What's up? I'm Jacob. Carry My Wayward Son is characterized by many literary devices found in poetry, and the lyrics themselves make the song poetic. The literary devices used in the song are symbolism, hyperbole, oxymorons, metaphor, simile, imagery, and characterization. A few of these examples can be found in the lyrics. When the singer says, "Through my eyes, could I still see I was a blind man?" That's an oxymoron. And when a simile was used, toss about like a ship on the ocean, when you use the word like. The lyrics within each stanza of this song are also very poetic. So the beginning two lines for every stanza, as well as the chorus, have end rhymes, meaning that the last word to each of the first two lines end in a rhyme. The repetition of the rhymes, use of literary devices, and the use of minimalism, and the entirety of this song provides easily relatable emotions for the listener.
Hi, I'm Brianna, and today I'm going to talk about the rhythm. Rhythm refers to specific patterns in time, and we usually hear this pattern in relation to a steady pulse or beat. Beats are organized into meters. There's duple meter, triple meter, and quadruple meters. This song is divided into a quadruple meter, or four beats. Also, it uses triplet subdivisions. The speed of the beat is referred to as a tempo. This song has a fast tempo of 127 beats per minute. This song also uses uneven beats or shuffle rhythm.
What's up, James?
Hey, I'm James, and I was talking about melody. One thing you can pick out in this song is a riff. There's a bass riff, piano riff, and guitar riff in this song. And as y'all know, the riff was around the time period of late 1800s, early 1900s. And the person who came up with piano riff, Scott Joplin, Ragtime, he was an African American. And he was the first one who came up with Ragtime. And it's a blend, Ragtime is a blend of European classical styles and African American harmony and rhythm, and that's what this song has in it, a bunch of riffs.
Hi, I'm also going to talk about instrumentation. Each group member had an important role to produce many of the songs. Phil Ehart played the drums as well as the percussion. Rich Williams was in charge of the rhythm guitar. Billy Greer had the bass as well as vocals. Steve Walsh had the keyboard, the synthesizer, the percussion, and he had vocals. Robbie Steinhardt had the violin vocals. Dave Hope had the bass and back vocals. And Carrie Livren was the lead guitar.